Now it's time for Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Welcome, Chris.
Hey, thanks, Paul.
Glad you're here. We haven't had a show in a while.
I know. I've missed it.
And we're back, and then we're going to be gone for a while.
Yeah, I guess folks better love this show because we'll be gone for a little bit.
But in the words of Boogie, the world needs Past Week, Next Week. And he's not here.
Right.
And neither is the texter. And we're excited to talk about what their adventures are getting into. But that's all well and good. Everyone's excited about everything I just said.
Really?
But they're like, that's all great, Paul. But you usually start the show with a song that symbolizes last week. And the fun part of it is, Chris, you have to try to guess. You have no help.
No.
You have no help.
I am boogie-less today, and that's scary.
And the texter, too.
I know. It's like going without a net, you know?
So here we go. We're going to try to see if you can get it. Is Barbara Streisand and Barry Gibb with the song, their collaboration. And the name of the song is Guilty on Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul.
Huh, okay.
Starring Boogie and also introducing the text.
I'm glad you got that in. It gave me a little more time to think about why you might have picked this song. Let me say I love this song.
I do too.
Yeah.
I've watched a couple of the Bee Gees things and documentaries, rockumentaries, if you will.
Sure.
If you will, will you?
Yeah, okay. I will.
So Barry Gibb and his brothers were great writers.
Yeah.
It was fun to like hear all these different things that they wrote too.
Yeah.
And he deliberately did this because it's like, man, people have had the Bee Gees a little bit too much. I'm going to try to do something a little bit different.
Hey, this is exciting, Paul. Sorry, but we just got a text from the texter.
What?
Yeah. Yes.
Can he guess what? Why we picked the song?
Let's see.
We have lots to be given.
Dear Past Weeks, another time. I am currently in the air over the Atlantic, but the listeners have asked if the best trip you could conceivably take would be to Croatia.
Well, you know what? Can we put that to the side as a facilitator? Put that to the parking lot?
Sure, yeah.
Because we'll be talking about trips.
I gotcha.
Okay. Now, here's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
You have no fucking clue why I picked this. No. I mean, because it's not very obvious at all about
what's
been
why.
In the news. Oh, you think you got it, huh?
Yeah, it's because my dad thought Barbra Streisand was the sexiest woman alive. Yep. I got it.
You know what? Sexiest woman alive?
Yeah, he.
That's exaggerated, but I can see where. See where he's getting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You ever seen the Owl and the Pussycat?
Yeah, I think she's something.
Yeah. Yeah. So is that why you picked it?
Yeah. No, this actually, that is good enough reason, but it has something to do with the news. Of this week.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's probably because former President Trump was found guilty on 34 felony counts in the New York State judicial system.
Convicted felon Donald Trump, 34 counts.
I was shocked that all of them were guilty.
And he has lots to be guilty of. our Lord, I don't know what they call him.
Dear leader. Yeah.
I never anticipated him. I thought it would be what's called a hung jury. Oh!
Hey-o!
But 34.
Yeah.
12 people had to agree 34 times.
34 times, all 12. And what did it take, 2 days?
Yeah.
2 days to agree on 34 counts.
Yes.
Wow.
And the unreported, or I think it's reported, but the people that are watching Fox News and want to believe Trump's lies.
Yeah.
There were 12 people in a room with stuff.
Yeah.
They heard things, then they got documents, and there was just 12 of them. And they decided this.
Yes. Yes.
They could have easily said, you know, the judge was corrupt or whatever thing that was going on, but they did this.
Yeah. Yeah. Holy smokes, man. Yeah. I saw a funny, they were showing what each of the cable news networks were showing the night after the conviction. And I know Fox talked about it, but it was CNN, you know, all about the guilty verdict. C-SPAN, all about guilty. MSNBC, and then Fox News. These items are going to be leaving the Taco Bell menu soon. So, you know. Oh, wait. Okay, they just keep coming. So.
Okay. That was Guilty by Barbara Streisand and Barry Gibb. Maybe it's to our MAGA friends, because we got nothing to be guilty of. But you do. You have lots to be guilty of. And you're guilty yourself, MAGA people. So anyway, that is that is legendary. Two legendary performers, Barry Gibbs and Barbara Streisand. Mm-hmm. Welcome to Past Week, Next Week, Chris and Paul, starring Boogie, introducing the texter.
I'm Chris.
What's up, sucker?
Sorry, Boogie. I'm Paul. This is a show where we review the most important things past week and get you ready for the next week. It's your one-stop program to keep you updated. It's a real week review. Just listen to us. You won't need any other information outlet. That's our guarantee.
Ooh.
I sometimes forget about that.
Yeah.
Because people are listening right now, and they're feeling guilty. What?
Yeah. How would they know?
Right.
We haven't been on the air in weeks.
Right, and they don't have
any. They have no other outlet.
They listen to no other outlet. So anyway, you said it. Trump got guilty of something. So there you go. That's all you need. Okay. Yeah.
You're caught up.
Thanks for listening to us online at kctkradio.com. And sometimes the streaming. So if this was a terrestrial radio.
Sure.
Let me just put it this way. If I would get in the hot tub time machine and go back to the 70s and have a terrestrial radio station.
Right.
But I live in modern times.
Yeah.
You're so I can't just
online.
I can't just go out and jiggle the antenna.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Is that a euphemism?
That was my pickup way. So I had to go in this morning and make sure the stream was correct.
Is that another euphemism?
We're 12 years old.
Yes,
we are. Anyway, you can listen to us. And I don't know if you can listen to us. If you have the internet.
Yeah.
And let's say you're above, I don't know, the ocean, and you're listening to it. You can listen to the KCTK radio smartphone app.
Man.
And that's exciting because I'm going to be listening to, if I go to Europe soon, I'm going to be listening to KCTK radio on my
non-stop
KCTK radio
phone
app. If you don't have it on the app, just download it right now. It's free. You can join the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We welcome your participation. Coming up, we have a weekly news quiz, pop culture update, incredible special feature, headlines and predictions, and much, much more. But first, let's see what is going on with Chris.
Yeah.
Every episode, I say, what's going on?
Yeah.
Because of our whole panel of you, Boogie, Texter, and myself.
Yeah.
But what I'm getting as far as the letters are, we don't care about those other guys. We only care about what's going on with Chris.
Really? People are saying that?
Yes.
I've suspected it for a while.
Love Chris's mom.
Yeah. Thanks, Mom. I love you. Yeah, so we've been gone for a few weeks. I guess maybe the biggest thing of note for me was able to go out of town with my kids.
Okay, that was the first week. No, wait. The first weekend that we were gone.
Yeah, how long has it been? I don't even remember.
The first weekend we were gone was Mother's Day.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
What did you do on Mother's Day?
Mother's Day was actually so very fun. So let me tell you this. For Mother's Day, I called early because we had a group of 13. So I called in March, and I'm going to say the names, to get a reservation for brunch. And
where?
I called 3rd Street Social down on the plaza.
Okay.
Yep, sir, we got you.
Which kind of pisses me off for such a cool restaurant.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's not 3rd Street.
You're right.
Okay.
But, yeah. It's not the 3rd Street in Lee Summit.
Why don't they just call it Main Street Social?
Yeah, that would be better.
Okay.
And make social. That's their brand.
Back to you, Chris.
Anywho, Jane was sitting next to me. It was on speakerphone. They got me down. And then Thursday before Mother's Day, Jane's like, hey, did you ever get a confirmation from 3rd Street Social?
Oh, sounds like the game show thing.
Uh-huh. So I call, no, sir, we don't have you down. And I was polite. I just said, well, that's very disappointing. Mm-hmm. And then I had to scramble to find a place on the Friday before Mother's Day where 13 people could get in. And I'm going to give props to Katie at Brown and Low in the River Market.
Ooh.
I called every place I could. When I called Katie, she's like, oh, my God. She goes, that's terrible. She goes, I'll tell you what. We have not opened up our patio for seating yet because we want to make sure it's not going to rain. So I can get you guys in if it's not going to rain. And sure enough, Brown and Low got us in. So we had brunch on the patio at Brown and Low. And then we went and all had our Christmas present from my lovely mother-in-law, Norma. And we got to go see Little Shop of Horrors. Little Shop of Horrors at the...
All 13 of you went?
Yeah, at the Missouri Rep. Yeah.
Sounds like a complete nightmare.
Dude, that play was so good.
No, like, I'm not talking about the play. I'm talking about planning everything and getting with everybody and the in-laws.
So did all of that and then came home and picked up my mother and took her to dinner that night. It was a long day. So
I'm like thinking, well, I need to do something for my mommy, mm-hmm. right?
Right. Your mommy.
There was already a scheduled brunch at my brother's house because she loves him the most.
Right.
So that's good. I went over there.
Uh-huh.
My wife didn't because she's like, listen, I don't have a mother anymore. I'm the mother. I want to just chill out. And so she doesn't like to. She just
good for
wants
her
to chill out. And we went over there and fought about politics with my.
Oh, that sounds
my
fun.
Parents and this is something to just bring up. There in every family, I think your family's the same. I don't know about Boogie and the Texter, but my guess. There are these things called gay people.
Right.
Okay.
Yes.
We love them so very much.
Yep. It's their month. Happy Pride Month, everyone.
Oh, yeah. Happy Pride Month. So when mentioned, you know, you don't want Trump to win because the Supreme Court already says they reverse things. They're Clarence Thomas already mentioned they should look at that.
Yeah, they'd look at marriage. Yep.
Guess what the answer was from these Trump supporters?
They don't care?
No. Oh, no, they would never reverse that.
Oh, my gosh.
And what was fun about the discussion was usually you have four men that were there who've been very involved in politics,
mm-hmm.
two women who were married to them. The two women went crazy.
Good for
and
them.
And said, are you nuts? They've already reversed stuff that we thought was regular law.
Yeah.
So why would you think that this wouldn't be one of them?
They're being willfully ignorant.
Yes.
Willfully ignorant. Sorry, I'm talking about your family.
Everyone's got family like that.
Oh, yeah.
So, and then my daughters came over to make dinner for their mother, for Mother's Day.
Oh, that's nice.
So that was nice. And then they're like, Dad, you need to get the grill going. And I'm looking around going.
It is here, Mother's Day.
Let's do this.
Okay.
And scene. Because it's not my mother.
That's a good point. That's a fair point. Yeah. Yeah.
And I know. When you got little kids, okay, I get it, but.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So anyway, sorry to jump on what's going on with you.
Hey.
I just thought I'd throw out that Mother's Day.
Yeah, no, so I appreciate it, and it's always good to celebrate mothers. You know, mothering is a very hard job. You are typically the main parent, not always, of course, but mm-hmm. typically you're the main parent.
Like, I can think of an exception.
Yeah. but you're also the parent that kids will get the most angry with and act out to them. It's a lot. Being a mom is a lot. Thank you, all the mothers. It's late, but appreciate you.
I don't know why there's a whole week for Pride and not a whole sorry, let me try this again. Take two. I don't know why there's a whole month for Pride and not even a whole month for mothers.
Dude, I saw, oh God, it was so funny. This guy, he goes and interviews MAGA people all the time. And he's in his hat and shirt, and he's talking to all these MAGA people yesterday. And they're at a rally, and they all have their shirts and hats and waving their flags. And he's coming up going, hey, can we talk about Pride Month? Can you believe these people?
Oh, yeah.
They deck out in all this stuff. They wave their flags. They wear their hats, and they make it their whole identity. Isn't that just disgusting?
Okay, so that guy's name, Walter Mathewson.
Is it? Okay, I don't know his name.
And he does a podcast called We Are Not Journalists. And
good
it's
one.
A weekly one. It's pretty good. Yeah, him and his buddy who do that. And they're just we're not journalists, we're joking around. Which I love the whole premise of.
Yes. And the people that they don't know they're in water. They're fish that don't know they're in water. So
okay, so after Mother's Day.
Yeah, after Mother's
then
Day.
And the next week you went to San Diego. Which
in German means a whale's vagina.
Yep.
Yes. So went there, a little trip to celebrate Abby, a little late to the game because she graduated in December, but...
Hey, that's on her. She had to work.
I know. She got a job right away and so had to wait till she had a little vacation time. And originally, it was going to be me, Jane, Molly, and Abby. Jane got very sick the day before the trip and lost her voice completely. And it's still not back all the way, which is a little bit scary. Tested negative for COVID. Anyway, thank God she didn't go because we left on Friday night. We were supposed to get in San Diego at 9 p.m. So the idea was, hey, we'll land, we'll go get a bite to eat. And, well, that didn't happen because we got delayed 7 hours in Kansas City. Finally, were able to make it to Phoenix and then had to spend the rest of the night there and got to San Diego at 9 a.m. Saturday morning with no sleep. So that's a tough way to start out a trip, but man, we had a good time. Just had a ball. This trip was really about Abby's Instagram, if I'm just honest with everyone. So she had restaurants picked out that she wanted to go because she wanted her picture in those restaurants. We went to a lovely winery, just absolutely gorgeous up in the mountains outside San Diego. So that we could get some lovely pics, which we did. Abby had a half a glass of wine and then was done with it, but got some good shots. But my God, I cried so many times just being with my kids and just like feeling that bond again of when it.
I'm going to mention this without going into it. There was times when it was just you three.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that probably came back and then where you were, what you've done and where you are now and what they've done with their life. And
oh my God, just so, so proud of them and just felt the love so strong. And it was like, I'm getting misty.
They're amazing.
They're
really amazing people. I mean, like I look at any success I had is I had parents, like I had a good father. What happens if you don't have that? You know what I mean?
Yes.
And now we know.
Now we know. Yeah. And I think I told you this. I had an interesting talk with Molly. I'm like, you know, why do you think you are thriving right now? And Molly's like, yeah, Dad, I don't know why every kid my age isn't thriving because we all grew up playing Sims. Sim City, Sim whatever. She goes, and you know.
Kids my age.
Yes. You know, to keep your sim happy, there's like different areas of life. You got to work on the social area. You've got to work on the work. You've got to work on your resources. You've got to work on like having a challenging enough job. I don't know if any of this is true because I never played Sims, but Molly's like, so I just apply that to my life now. And these are like the five areas that I'm always evaluating. Am I happy in this area or do I need to be doing something different? And I'm like, wow, that's fascinating.
My kids played Sims.
And your kids are doing great.
Yeah, maybe that's something.
I don't know. Yeah, so I think Molly should write a blog post or something about that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So anyway, we did that and had a lovely time. And
that last weekend?
That was 2 weeks ago. Okay, so ago. What was last weekend?
We didn't do it because one of our guys went to Croatia.
Right.
And this is, I don't know if you know this or not. This is a kind of a big deal.
Yeah.
There's always been, so we always have the texter. He's been with us for a while.
Oh, yeah.
He's pre-boogie even.
Yeah, he is pre-boogie. He's PB.
Yeah, he's PB. And then every once in a while we have also featuring Brian.
Right.
They do not get along.
No. But oil and water, baby.
Brian invited the texter to go to his Croatian.
Wow.
So they're together.
It's quite an olive branch.
Yes.
Man.
So they went to Croatia together.
Holy
cow. And I'm getting pictures of I get pictures from Brian. I got pictures from the texter about Croatia.
Oh my gosh!
And I think that they even have it. So it's really interesting to see a budding friendship.
Yeah, man. I hope it takes root and really grows strong.
And I guess we could have done a show. Boogie has been spending lots of time. I guess he's the new. I can't remember the name of the famous agent for the. What's the name of the guy? Ari.
Oh, he's Ari Fleischer.
Ari Fleischer. He's an agent for a sports guy.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's.
Well, okay. Ari was, I think, entertainment, but Tom Condon.
He's the new Tom Condon. He goes around and every weekend is consumed with his sons.
Yeah.
Working on their football skills and then getting into a new program. Let's use this as an opportunity. You want to share with everybody what he told us yesterday?
I guess so. I kind of feel bad sharing his news, but if we don't share it, it's going to be weeks before people hear.
That's right.
So Boogie, I'm doing this out of love, but I wish it could be you sharing the news. But essentially, Joseph, Boogie's son, has gotten multiple offers to like Division II schools. Yesterday, he got an offer from the University of North Dakota to go play football for them, which North Dakota is, you know, Division I. They are a perennial power. That is a big deal. But he also got an offer from Northwest Missouri State.
Yes.
Division II, my alma mater, but also a perennial power.
Perennial power. They are consistently good. They may have more championships than any other college. I don't know. Maybe.
Well, they do in Division II. They have more than any other Division II school.
They're a quality team. They cheat when they play Central Missouri, and they're really that's a great program.
Mm-hmm.
Sure, they let anybody in,
but then he's not here today because JoJo got invited to go to K-State, and maybe he's going to get an offer there too. So.
Yeah.
I am just so happy that kid got his mother's athletic skills.
No doubt.
I mean,
brains and everything.
Looks. Yeah.
Because he's a handsome kid, which is surprising.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Hey, we love you, Boogie. Yeah. Seriously. That is so exciting. I am just so thrilled for.
So that's exciting. Him. And, you know.
So go, JoJo.
You could give us a text and tell us what's going on. But, I mean, that's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. So. Maybe we could have had a show last week, but we kind of dropped the ball, I guess.
I guess, yeah.
But we were told by Boogie we need to continue, so here we are.
So here today. We are, carrying on. So good luck, Joseph. I know in theater you say break a leg, but I bet you don't say that in football, so I'm going to say good luck.
You know what the kids say is, let's go. I hate that. Let's go!
They say that all the time?
Yeah.
Yeah, kids.
I hate that.
Yeah.
Okay, so what? Anything else been going on?
I think that's the highlights there. So, yeah, there you go. What's going on with you?
A lot of people have been asking.
Yes. Cards and letters, I'm guessing.
No, telegrams. When was the last time we had... Okay, so here's something you missed. So, I went to a birthday party for our friend Velvy.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
And he turned a ripe old age. And like 50 years ago, we did a roast for him at his birthday.
Feels like it. Yeah.
And so we did a roast again, only I thought it was everyone coming around his house and doing a roast, but it was just me and you doing the roast.
Okay. Yeah. I thought it was supposed to be everybody too.
Yeah. But. And so you were unable to be there.
Right.
And it was pretty striking because you wrote all your roast jokes.
Right.
And then reminded me of it. And I'm like, he's never prepared this much for the show, but okay.
Dude, it took me about 15 minutes to write that out. Yeah.
But young Michael Blocker, Daniel.
Oh,
Daniel
okay.
Blocker, he presented you. Uh-huh. And it was actually good jokes.
Oh, okay.
And a better presentation than I've ever seen.
Well, I mean, of course.
So we killed. That was nice.
Yeah.
What else feel like I graduation parties, have you been hit with that at all?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah. I wonder if maybe I'm done with those.
Yeah, it's they come in waves, don't they?
They do. Yeah, they definitely do.
I was supposed to meet you on the 23rd, kind of.
You were. You kind of crapped out on me. Kind of
effed you on that one.
Yeah.
At Memorial Day, which was nice. Went to the pool a couple times.
Oh, yeah.
And I tell me what you think of this. So I have children that are grown children.
Right.
I had really at this point nothing to their life. Okay.
Yeah. And so, that's different from.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. So it's, well, financially, before I financially.
Okay. Yeah.
Good stuff. Okay. Now, but when my kids ask me to get they want to ride to the airport.
Mm-hmm.
I do that. Now, I have other people telling me that I'm really kind of crazy for doing that.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think? Keep in mind, I had to get up at 3 in the morning and take her to the airport.
On a work day?
No, it was Memorial Day.
So. Oh. Yeah, I think that's fine. I mean, I've picked Molly up from the airport before. I think it's a fine thing to do.
I mean, it's like, you know, you're a dad. That's right. What you do. You're there just to be a dad. My daughter, Madeline, is... I'm currently on an Alaska cruise.
I saw some pics. Looked lovely.
So that
is, how fun is that?
Yeah, and she went with all her buddies and stuff, and so that's a lot of fun. Some really bad news happened this last time we were off.
Yeah.
And if you want to go ahead and think about that's okay. Your thinking song. A friend of mine passed away. And he was known to this station because his girlfriend would do a podcast here, Tracy, of Tracy's Tips and Dips.
Yeah.
Hey, this is Tim Hughes.
Our buddy Tim Hughes died.
That's so sad.
He died of cancer and really a really great guy, really great friend. Got to go on a couple trips with him, actually several trips. Went to Chiefs games, went to cruises that Wyden couldn't go to.
Yeah.
He succumbed to cancer and fought it for many years. And they had a funeral yesterday. My brother Phil, he spoke. I don't have the funny thing about him right now, but I'll find it later.
Okay, good. You can fix it in post.
It'll say something like Attorney Phil Lavota is shocked. Yeah, here it is.
This segment brought to you by the law offices of Phil Lavota.
But he spoke, and it was very poignant and specific, and he mentioned people in Tim's families and how they meant to him, and then it was funny, as you can imagine. And,
yeah.
Because Tim was a real funny guy and fun-loving.
Mm-hmm.
And really brought everybody together.
I thought that.
What?
Attorney Phil Lavota is shocked.
Well, I would think so after that other thing. So anyway, that was kind of a terrible thing that happened.
Yeah, but that stinks.
But other than that, I mean, just been kind of plugging along a little bit with other duties.
You said duty.
And I don't know if I mentioned this on the air about getting sick.
I don't think so.
I know you know about this because we went and got our international driver's license.
Yes,
together.
We certainly did.
But I had this pain in my chest.
That's right. Yeah.
And it freaked me out.
Mm-hmm.
I was at night. It was pain in my chest. And my wife's like, do we need to go to the emergency room? I'm like, no. Because
it's not the right answer.
Because I'm going on a trip on starting Saturday and I didn't want to ruin the trip by going and getting,
by getting healthy
or dying before because it was too close to the trip.
It was close.
Well, come to find out, I made myself my own doctor's appointment, which is like, if I do that, I'm pretty worried.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay?
And it was, my heart's fine, my lung's fine. It was
costochondritis.
Costochondritis, mm-hmm. Which, as I'm learning, is like the most common thing in the world, and everyone is making fun of me. But, guys, it hurts a lot, but I'm a 56-year-old fat guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Don't F around with it,
you
man.
Don't F around, you know.
Yeah.
So
I'm so glad you're okay.
It freaked me out.
Yeah.
A little bit, but I'm good and
thank heavens.
The trip the trip will continue, and I'm just not going to plan. If I'm going to be sick, I could be like 6 months before a trip, and you die, and then you could, you know, easily get someone else to go.
Yeah,
to your spot.
I mean, yeah, Nancy could get your spot filled quickly. Yeah. Okay,
but see, here's my theory. My theory is it was so close. If she could find someone easily,
yeah.
Anyway,
yeah,
but she would go have the time of her life.
Mm-hmm.
And then have this pain of, should I be feeling so great about Paul not being here?
Right.
You know what I mean?
That would be tough for her.
A couple months later, then you can say, well, he'd be happy. I'm happy.
Yes.
But just such a short time, you'd be like.
I'm glad you were thinking of her.
Yes.
Yeah, that's
like,
nice.
That's ruin the whole trip if I'm dead.
Totally, dude.
Unless I die 6 months.
Right. Yes.
So anyway, that's what I've been doing. Let's see what the texter has to say.
Yeah, he's again prolific, even high above the ocean.
You want to read what he has to say?
Sure, let me pull it up here.
What?
Okay. So we've got, there's even one to me. So, okay. Another lesson from my first experience to Europe is that no one gives a shit about Felon DJT. He is merely a joke to them.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah. Dear past week, next time around, does it seem that the listener appreciation days have reduced in frequency? If this is not true, the listeners have let me know the publicity around the events is definitely not as prolific.
Huh. Yeah, no, we do them all the time. We're actually doing a listener appreciation trip on Saturday.
We certainly are.
Just we can get back to the text, but just we are leaving.
Yes.
You and I and our wives.
Mm-hmm.
Are going to Italy,
yeah,
Greece, and Turkey.
Yeah.
And we're going to be gone for 10 days.
Yeah.
And it's going to be a cruise, and then we're going to go to Sicily because my wife has family there. I have family there.
Yeah. I am so excited.
What do you think about going there? Sicily.
Sicily? I am so excited. Two reasons. A, you guys had such a great time on your trip there before. B, then I watched season 2 of White Lotus that took place in Sicily. Uh-huh. And all that HD footage, like it was one of the most gorgeous places I've ever seen.
Just to warn you, that is Eastern Sicily.
Okay.
We're going to be on Western Sicily.
Okay.
Last time we stayed to the south on the island by the beach, and I thought it was beautiful. So beautiful. Nancy's family we're like, can we stay there again? They're like, no, that place is garbage. You need to stay at the better place. So that we're staying at the better place.
Oh my gosh. I am so thrilled.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've never been to Europe. So this will be my first time going to Europe. It's cool. We get to hit three different countries. And then I know Sicily is part of Italy, but it's like its own region there. And I'm excited.
I'm going to go ahead and announce this. I haven't even talked to you about it, but I think you're going to be okay with it.
Okay.
okay. People will be like, well, you're going to be gone. How are you guys going to be able to do a show, right?
Yes.
But I have some interesting news that I can't find my drum roll for. Here it is. There will be special episodes of this podcast with Chris and Paul.
What?
Periodically on your timeline.
I'm excited.
Now, will this show up on the Facebook feed and stuff? It will be delayed.
Okay.
Okay. You'll see it there. But it will be on if you follow this like Apple Podcast or whatever.
Yeah.
And I guess there's no more Google Play. It's on through YouTube, which
Wow. Okay.
So you'll see you'll be notified that your podcast is there and you'll listen to it. I'm gonna bring all the equipment over with us. Although I'm gonna need your little help with some of the technical part of playing the music that we played before.
Ooh, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
And whatever you need me to do.
That involves you getting your phone over to YouTube.
I can do that. I know how to do that.
And we're going to do this periodically. So I envision when we're sitting down like gentlemen having breakfast, even if the girls don't want to be there, it'd be a great time to do a quick podcast and update for everybody.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're excited by that. Have you ever done a podcast in Europe?
No, I've never even been to Europe.
Okay, I've done one in the Mediterranean.
I've heard you. You were extremely drunk, as I recall.
Yes. So get used to that, folks.
Oh, boy.
And that will happen.
Yeah, that's exciting stuff.
Yeah. So, and where else were we? Now we're back to the texter.
Yes. So Dear Boogie Nights, do you think your son enjoys football? And he doesn't know that Boogie's not here. I'm embarrassed for him.
What's up, suckers?
Okay, just so everyone knows, this is me imitating
him. Oh, thank you for clarifying.
What is going on, suckers? My son plays football. I'm getting married.
Okay, so...
Hey, thanks for the update, Bugs. Now, here's one specific to me.
Oh.
Dear Chris Whiting.
Wait, has that ever happened?
I don't think it has. I think it's always Boogie Nights. So this is, this is unprecedented, folks. Dear Chris Whiting, I recall a time when you had a spaghetti dinner for the purpose of saving souls. As I remember, the amount of souls brought into salvation was at that time unknown, but the amount of fun that was had was immeasurable. That is absolutely true. We were at a youth leaders retreat thing somewhere, and I was in a group that the texter and his wife happened to be in that same group, and they were having everybody go around and talk about, you know, one of their most recent youth activities at the church, and everybody was talking about how kids' lives were changed.
And you hosted it?
No, I was. Oh, yeah, it was like a retreat. I was just there to learn how to be a better youth leader. And everybody
How's
was
that work?
you know.
Yeah.
But everybody's like, oh, and we had a whatever, and all of these kids were crying, and they really felt the Lord's Spirit and blah. And I'm going, oh, we haven't had anything where I've seen lives change. So when it came to me, I'm like, well, we had a spaghetti dinner. I don't know if we saved any souls, but, you know,
you
did. I don't know if we saved any souls, but the spaghetti was pretty good, and we had a lot of fun.
That's
and
awesome.
The texter and his wife thought that was the best thing they had ever heard, yes. I believe. So
that's why they enjoyed the pasta dinner at that my wife made for them so much.
Yes. Yeah. Exactly. So,
okay.
Here is a question I have from a listener I met in Europe. Why does Past Week Next Weekend not do a better job of marketing in Europe? There were not ads on public transport, no ads in literature about what to do in Zagreb. I don't know what that means. Go ahead.
I think it's clear. I mean, we are building an audience. We have a Canadian listener, so that's huge.
That's big.
That's big.
Thank you, Murph.
And you should follow him on Facebook because he has some funny stuff. But we are working with Molly Whiting, and that's yes. part of her thing.
Yeah. So. It's exciting.
So, yeah. Thanks for noticing that need. We noticed it too.
Yeah. I don't even want to do. Dear, this is the day the Lord has made. Please tell us your thoughts on Harrison Butker.
Yeah, that came up. So, I went to a graduation party right after that.
Uh-huh.
Annie Hogue graduated from star soccer player from Benedictine, and we went to her party. You'll know her and probably become very good friends with her because she's also going on the trip.
Oh, cool.
And I was told at the time, right after, the kicker from the Chiefs. I go, well, how was it? Oh, he droned on, is what people said. And I said, you know what? If you have the longest field goal in NFL history in Super Bowl, you get to drone on.
Yeah.
But then I learned what he said.
Yeah.
And I'm glad you brought this up because I have some strong feelings on this.
Okay.
And I know it's been a month, but here is something. If you read the book called Your Elected Representatives, I talk about this in my last chapter.
Mm-hmm.
I think we too much discount how we do things to focus on what we do.
Okay. Unpack that for us.
Okay. Let me give you the example of Harrison Buckner.
Okay.
Butker. Butker. If you listen to what he said, you would think, well, his words are okay. Maybe. Eh. But he came across like a dick.
Oh, yes.
A preachy man, asshole, who didn't balance, boys, you need to learn this, girls, you need to learn this. He came across as a real dick.
Yeah.
I am on the internet. He came across as a dick. Okay?
Okay. Yes.
There's a problem there. That's a problem.
Mm-hmm.
And too many times we think about, oh, the words. Oh, we have to, Let's get our emotions. People don't make decisions just on the words. They make decisions on the emotions as well. Everything that we do.
Yes.
When there's a trial for a guy who's sitting there being in contempt nine times, being an asshole, having his attorneys be assholes and the witnesses be assholes, that's going to affect things.
Yeah.
And it doesn't mean that, but people act like they only make decisions based on the facts.
Mm-hmm.
But how you do things is important because it's how you're treating other people.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And let's acknowledge that that's it. Someone else could have maybe done the exact same words, but Harrison Buckner came across like an asshole, holier-than-thou jerk.
Yeah.
And that's what he is.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And silver lining for me is when the Chiefs lose a game, I'm going to be happy that he lost. And even though I'm going to be sad that the Chiefs lost.
Right. Right.
Your thoughts on it?
I was very put off by parts of it. His attitude and his words toward the LGBTQ community, I took personal offense to when mm-hmm. he talked about, I'm not talking about the sinful pride that they have a whole month for. As the father of a non-binary gay person, I took personal offense to that. And I think the smugness and the arrogance that he's a 28-year-old guy that has an amazing gift. He doesn't live in the same world that the rest of us do.
And he thinks he can tell other people how to be Catholic. That is not. And the whole movement of the, I sent you that article about the Latin Mass movement, are trying to push aside the Pope.
Right.
The whole point of the Catholic Church, folks, is the Pope is infallible and you follow his direction.
Yeah. Yeah.
The smugness.
Yeah, the smugness, the arrogance, and then that he, as a man, can tell these women, hey, I know they will say, well, that's not the exact words he used, but tell these women, hey, good for you, you got a degree, but that's not what really matters. What matters for your life is for you to be a mother and a wife.
Mm-hmm.
And
I would say this, for all of our friends out there who are like, you know, being a mother and a wife and a is the most important thing. Yes. And that was part of his, I think it is. I think being part of a family is more important than any career that you have. I really do.
Yeah.
That's my belief.
Yeah.
That's not all he said. He came across like a dick.
Yeah.
And judgment, mean.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of people who feel that, yeah, we need to focus more on the family, who don't have that judgment, mean, criticism in him. So don't defend this guy. Say that was wrong the way he presented it.
Yeah. Yeah. And then, you know, there's backlash and people get all, well, how, no, he has, you can't. Yeah. We can react to what he said. We absolutely can.
Yes.
He has the right to say whatever he wants to under the First Amendment. We have a right to react to it. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. He acted like an asshole, smug, arrogant. God, there's just nothing I came away with going, oh, you know what? I really like that Butker guy.
Okay. Do you think he should be kicked off the team?
Absolutely not.
I completely agree with you. If he was, I wouldn't give a shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I don't think he should be kicked off the team.
No.
I think these petitions that he should be kicked off the team and petitions that he shouldn't be are so stupid.
It's just, it's just noise.
Yes.
The Chiefs have an excellent kicker. They're not going to go, oh, there's 200,000 signatures on a change.org. No.
And those of you who think, well, he acted like a jerk and then they took it out on Colin Kaepernick. Two rights don't make it wrong, folks. It's just they shouldn't have done that to Colin.
No.
But guess what? Colin's not as good of a quarterback as Harrison is as a kicker.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm sorry it works out that way. Now, my wife went last night to the Big Slick.
Oh, uh-huh. Wait, is that another euphemism?
No, but it was Jason Sudeikis and Paul Rudd and those guys. And they did a little skit because they had George Wendt there.
Oh, really?
They did the Bears guys.
Yeah.
And they did a little skit where they were being the Bears guys and they interviewed Travis Kelce.
Oh.
And the big joke of the night was, when are you going to make your girlfriend an honest woman? And he's like, I don't know. He goes, well, that kicker of yours sure thinks you should.
Now, that's hilarious.
That's pretty funny. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. So there, we had our say on that. That's good.
Okay.
And what does the texter have to say about
that? So
he's up in the air. You know that.
Here we go. Please regale us with a story from a recent 60th birthday party. Check. Here's a little bit of trivia for you. The Office was available on Netflix in Europe. Well, that is trivial.
That is nice.
One of my favorite things to do was go into a bakery in the morning and order some pastries in the native language and totally pass as a local.
Dude.
I don't believe that.
So I've been doing this program I found that helped me speak Italian.
Yeah.
And I've been haven't been doing the Candy Crush, which I spent 20 hours a day on.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. I've been doing this.
Yeah.
The first lesson was how to order a croissant and coffee. And I'm like, yes, this is exactly what I need.
Can you do it now? Do you know it?
I don't want to put myself for that much ridicule.
Okay. I was wanting to learn it.
But I can understand it a little bit, and it's hard. Man, I really messed up. If I go back in the hot tub time machine, I would make myself learn it when I was a kid. But anyway, I can imagine how fun it was for them to go and get something and try to pass off as a native. I don't think I'm going to be able to pull that off anywhere. I think in a weird, you know, we have this melting pot. I have family from Italy, whatever. I'm a fucking American. I look like an American. I dress like an American.
Yes.
I'm a big, dumb American.
Yeah.
God love you. I'm fat like an American. There's just, I can't.
Yeah.
It's just the way it is.
Yeah.
Okay. Back to the texter.
Okay. Oh, I went to a winery that's been in the same family since 1492. If you remember, that's the same year Christopher set sail for spice.
Yeah.
Huh. And then here's one for you. Did you know that Cambridge University was started before the Aztec Empire?
I did know that.
Yeah, I've heard that trivia before.
It comes up on the TikTok sometimes.
Yeah, crazy.
Yeah, so that's what we've been up to. And we a lot of announcements in there, a lot of good stuff going on there. But let's get to, oh my gosh, we have some on this text line.
Oh!
Let's get to this.
Yeah, this is exciting.
Okay, that was the worst What's Up Suckas I've ever heard in history of What's Up Suckas. Show me the money.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Jerry Maguire, that's what we should have
said. Maguire, that's it. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Good job, Boogie.
Here, let's fix that real quick.
What is up, suckers? I'm Jerry Maguire now.
Oh, man, so, that was spot on.
Spot on, yeah.
Man, I turned into Renee Zellweger when you said that.
Thank you. What? So let's go to the news quiz.
There's been
news that happened, and a lot of people are wondering, which news quiz will you be using? And that's a great question for us, too, because we like to use the news quiz to test how much we know about news, but also kind of use it as an opportunity to start talking about things that happened in the past week.
Mm-hmm.
We're boogie-less.
I know. That's sad.
We're texterless. So how will we be able to answer these questions?
Now we're going to give it our best shot.
Okay. The Supreme Court in which state ruled the Civil War era total abortion ban is enforceable, superseding a 15-week... Wait a minute. What year? Is this week's?
April 12th, 2024.
All right.
Yeah. Holy cow.
Let's go back.
I'm like, wait a minute.
Sorry about that, guys.
We'll fix it in post.
Okay. Let's go.
You want to try this? Okay. Yeah. I miss the Slate News Quiz. I think it's better than the CNN.
I do, too. I think it is. To me, it seems more relevant, but also a little challenging more than CNN.
Mm-hmm.
CNN and their both sidesism makes me sick.
Oh, yeah.
Is that it? Yep. There you go. Okay. Dun, 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 dun. Just kind of repeating again. We did get that one right, so let's.
By the way, I don't know if you saw George Conway go off on the both sideism when he was on CNN.
It was awesome.
It was lovely.
And then,
God,
and then
I loved
the gal who's the queen of it, Casey Hunt, there. That's our colleague. Shut up.
Yes.
He was lying about it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Alvin Bragg did not run to get Trump. That is a lie.
Yes. And I love that he's using the word lies. Yes. I feel like people hold back on that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Which country's president and foreign minister were killed in a helicopter? Wait a minute. That seems old, too.
Yeah.
But that's it. It was Iran, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
So Iran died. You know, with such the volatile, thank you, situation over there, sure, it's a question if it was sabotage or anything, but
sure.
It wasn't.
Yeah.
Evidently, it wasn't.
Yeah.
So that was boring. It was relevant this week that which U.S. Supreme Court justice flew an American flag upside down, the symbol of Stop the Steal movement.
Yeah, Alito.
Yep, Alito. And it sounds too much like Sam Lavoda, which pisses me off. That's one thing that pisses me off.
Okay, I could see that, okay? Yeah.
But the fact, okay, I'm not like, I forgot to put my flag out on Memorial Day.
Oh, uh-huh.
And I'm not wave the stars and stripes guy, but I do put my flag out. I have reverence for the flag.
Mm-hmm.
And I do, if people burn the flag as a protest, I don't want them to go to prison, but I don't like that. I am insulted that someone would have an upside down flag.
Yeah.
The deep meaning and the extra effort that you have to do that.
Yes.
Should they go to jail? No, they have a freedom. But someone at the highest level would mm-hmm. do that is such a disgusting thing for our country and its system.
Yeah.
It makes me sick. And then this coward, this Alito,
mm-hmm.
well, that was my wife's flag.
Yeah.
Screw you, buddy. Why can't you just say, listen, I'm on the Supreme Court. You can't get rid of me. I disagree with what's going on. My wife wanted to put the flag on. I say, absolutely, I agree with you. Mm-hmm. Just stop hiding behind your wife.
Yeah.
And I love the commentary. Oh, yeah, she has a right to do that, but you would give her the right to make her own health care decisions. Have you heard that one?
I haven't heard that one. Yeah. Gosh.
With it, here's the other thing that the media makes me so mad. They also, on their travel home or their vacation home, they had this appeal to heaven flag. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's also been a new symbol of the Christian nationals. Guess what? I don't fucking know that. Okay. I know it's an oldie time. They used it during the Revolutionary War. Mm. I'm not mad they did that. I don't care.
Yeah.
Your symbol doesn't mean anything to me. What does mean something to me is our American flag, and you flew it upside down.
Mm-hmm.
Stop. When we got these guys to do something bad, let's talk about what they do bad as opposed to conflating stuff. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, no. Not the appeal to heaven flag. What the hell is that?
Yeah. Who cares?
Right.
Yes.
These are the same group of people, too, who care so much about flags. Oh, my God. You can't have a multicolored flag in it.
Yeah.
Anywhere. Oh, my God.
All the symbols, man.
Yeah.
Just interested in the symbols, not the substance.
We were talking before that the Senate Democrats have asked Chief Justice to come talk about all these
mm-hmm.
improprieties of the Supreme Court. They won't show up.
They won't come talk. Yeah.
And I was saying that I think it should have hearings about all this mm-hmm. stuff. There's no accountability to these people.
Yeah.
They seem bought and paid for. We know that at least three of them lied to Congress
mm-hmm.
about what they were going to do.
Yep.
We know that two of them have spouses that are actively involved with insurrection
with
and
overturning
our government.
God. Oh.
And I just don't understand why. Well, I'm going to take a way step back here. I believe now, you know me as a little kid, all I wanted to do was be a senator.
Yeah, and find Playboy magazines in the wood.
No, I did that.
Okay.
Actually, my ambition was to be a United States senator.
Mm-hmm.
I got to be a Missouri state senator.
Yeah.
I now believe that the Senate is antiquated and we don't need it.
Yes. Dude, I'm with you.
And this whole, the Supreme Court's worse, but the Senate, well, we're senators and we have this responsibility. We can't subpoena the Supreme Court. We are fighting for our democracy with both hands tied behind our backs.
Yes.
Against people who don't care about our norms, our traditions, and our structures of government.
Yeah.
But we can be on our high horse and go, well, we shouldn't subpoena them.
Yeah.
The whole setup of our government, folks, is three co-equal branches of government. And designed in there is fights among them.
Yes. Yeah. It's based on conflict.
It's based on conflict. So fight them.
Yeah.
When they're wrong, fight them.
Yeah.
Because sure as hell, if the Supreme Court thinks that the Congress is wrong, they'll fight them.
Oh.
And the president and on and on and on.
Yeah.
These people are disgusting. I can't believe that they actually think that they have this ownership of patriotism. Okay, let's go to the next question.
Okay.
Who accused prosecutor Karmeen Khan of a new anti-Semitism after Khan issued a warrant for their arrest?
It's got to be Netanyahu.
Yeah, Netanyahu, who, again, talk about a complete terrible person.
Yeah, awful human being.
He violates international law.
Mm-hmm.
He is doing warfare that is similar to what they say Germany did.
Don't you mean lawfare?
Yeah.
No, I'm kidding.
No.
Yeah.
And then he hides behind anti-Semitism.
Yeah. Ugh. Yeah. He's awful.
It's disgusting. It's disgusting. And I am also sick of everyone blaming Joe Biden for what this guy does.
I know.
I don't know what else he's supposed to do except be against terrorism and help an ally. You got this asshole here. I don't know what he's supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
You can't cut him off. You can't. I don't know what he's supposed to do except do the right thing, which is what he's doing.
Yeah.
Okay. Question four. A London court has agreed to allow which man to appeal the extradition order that would send him to America to face espionage charges.
Is it Assange?
It's Assange. Yeah. I don't know a lot about this.
I don't either.
There's a lot of people who think that he was just a journalist and the government's after him.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know the truth of it.
I know. Last I heard, his girlfriend was.
What?
Pam Anderson.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Well, I had no idea.
So, congratulations on that.
Yeah.
I'm going to feel sorry for you for extradition. I mean,
hey, I can't believe we've gotten four right.
Got four right.
Yeah, what's going on here?
Okay. Which restaurant chain announced that it filed for relief under Chapter 11 bankruptcy?
I think it's Red Lobster.
Red Lobster is right.
Yeah. Is the one in Independence still open? I don't even know.
I don't know. But I love me some Red Lobster food. I don't really enjoy going there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We would take it. We'd get it as takeout every once in a while. It's Red Lobster. It's good, but then it's like, this is too much.
Yeah. Yeah.
What would...
Those Cheddar Bay biscuits are good, man.
In the last, I'd say, 10, 15 years,
mm-hmm.
I mean, you want to go to a Third Street Social.
Yeah.
You want to go to Red Lobster.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Is Applebee's even around anymore?
There's one in Blue Springs that I know of. Yeah.
And even a chain like 54th Street, which I like, that's mm-hmm. just a local chain.
Yeah.
Do you think it's the quality or what do you think made people say, I'm done with these chains?
I think it is the quality.
Yeah.
I will say, I don't know, we had our nieces several months ago and they wanted to go to Chili's. I had not been to Chili's in forever. It was not good.
Yeah.
At all.
So last weekend I went to the
biggest character.
Oh no!
Forget Paul. Probably be Paul.
I forgot to do that. I'm gonna go back to that. But went to the Independence Center.
Mm-hmm.
And it's dying inside.
There. Oh yeah, yeah.
Now, my wife says, "Isn't it sad?" Your thoughts on that, Chris? Because is it sad? Because things change, okay?
Yeah.
And we got to get used to that because my wife can say it's sad, but I sure do look at the Amazon bill that we get. You know what I mean? And
well,
I'm guilty of it myself.
Here's why I think it's sad, and I do the Amazon stuff too. Independence is becoming empty storefront after empty storefront after empty restaurant. Mm-hmm. Everything is closing up here. So I've done some shopping for this trip that we have coming up. You go over to Lee's Summit, I don't remember the name, but where their Target is and where their Dick's Sporting Good is. Mm-hmm. It's like two separate outdoor shopping areas. There's actually people there. There's uh-huh. people out shopping, milling about, and you just don't see that in Independence
well,
anymore.
And the sad thing about Independence was that it was all about strip malls and retail, retail, retail.
Mm-hmm.
I remember a guy who ran and said, "This is enough." We got a picture of him in front of the Bass Pro
Shop.
Yeah,
that's very true.
We're going to stop paying for all this retail stuff.
Yeah.
I think by that time it was a little too late.
I think it was.
But we can't, we shouldn't be like old generations and just, we got to understand things change.
Mm-hmm.
And be creative with what type of quality of life we want to have. I think too many times in states, maybe even countries, certainly communities, we try to compare ourselves to something else.
Mm-hmm.
We're never going to be Lee's Summit.
No. But we've got to be something different in Independence. Yes. I don't know what that is,
yeah.
But I mean, and it's newer strip malls. I say newer, like built within the last 20 years that are essentially empty.
I know.
I mean, Nolan Fashion Square is way older than that, but that's a desolate zombie apocalypse area.
So they're going to, they found a dead guy there one time a couple weeks ago in there. They're going to tear those down and build patio homes.
Okay. Well, that's
better.
Which I think
is great.
Yeah. Yeah.
The other thing that we don't have in our town, and I don't think anyone does, is houses, starter houses anymore.
No.
So.
Yeah.
Maybe that would be a way to do it. I jokingly kept telling the mayor, if I was mayor, I'd just tear everything down. They're tearing things down now.
That's good. That's good.
So yeah. I thought, well, I guess I don't need to run for mayor.
Oh, well, there you go. You got that off your plate.
Yeah. Hey, I participated in the Independence Chamber of Commerce situation called Lead Class.
Yeah.
Where you learned about the city and you were there with some other business people, and you learn about the city and learn about leadership.
Mm-hmm.
Then we had this big graduation.
Yeah.
And they made a video before of asking us what we thought of Independence, what we thought of the class. And I have a very embarrassing video.
Oh.
The sound from it, okay?
Okay, I'm excited.
I'm sitting there watching it, and this is what I get to watch.
The biggest character.
I could definitely not forget Paul.
Probably be Paul. I definitely think Paul would have to be the biggest character. He's just so funny. He just really has that personality to kind of lighten the mood.
He's very outgoing, very funny, always is making you laugh and making you feel good.
He's just got a joke for everything and just, like, adds liveliness to any conversation.
He's extroverted, he's friendly, he's funny, you know, and it's kind of a natural thing for him, and so he's just really easy to be around, and he makes it enjoyable.
Yeah. Was that you or Paul Lynn they're talking about?
That was me.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Dude.
So I can't wait to play this for Boogie so he knows.
Dude, you know. You're the biggest character in the entire Lead program.
Uh-huh.
I'm not surprised.
I think I got a call, too. I think we did some focus groups about uh-huh. people, what they thought of the show.
The biggest character.
I could definitely not forget Paul.
Probably be Paul. I definitely think Paul would have to be the biggest character.
So I think definitely that is talking about our panel and me.
Yes.
Being the funniest there ever has been. I was so freaking embarrassed.
Were you?
Yes. And then, of course, friend of the program, Teresa Garza's there.
I love Teresa.
Yelling,
yay!
Embarrassing the hell out of me.
Well, you would have done the same to her. Let's be clear yes. about that.
But it happened.
Well, congrats, man.
Well, no. Well, then I had the problem. I shared it with people I work with.
Uh-huh.
And so I had to go company-wide. Congratulations.
That's awesome.
No.
Yes, it's great, man.
Oh, my God.
I'm a big character.
Dude,
own
I'm
it.
Mortified. Who's the biggest character? That's a fat joke right there.
I wasn't going to go there, but yes, okay. It's hilarious.
I think you were.
Okay. In my mind.
Okay, so I'm sorry I forgot about that, everybody.
Well, I'm glad you shared that. That was really cool.
It was.
Are you going to like it when I cut that apart and talk about how funny I am all the time?
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. We've talked and we've meandered on, and it's time to take a break.
Oh, yeah, I got a tinkle.
We'll be right back with more Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul, starring Boogie and introducing the Texter.
Looking at the past 7 days so you don't have to. You could join in on the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060.
We've been told that perfect mornings exist for the lucky few. That morning people own the waking hours. But the truth is, mornings belong to all of us. Your mornings are what you make of them. Takes is saying yes. Starbucks morning yes.
Look for Starbucks coffee in a grocery store near you, then sit back and enjoy the exceptional taste of Starbucks at home.
Hi, this is Chickless Goose from Counterclockwise KC. Listen to our program each and every Saturday and Sunday at 7 p.m. right here on KCTK Radio. Personality driven radio.
Hi guys, it's your old friend Paul from KCTK Radio, reminding you again to download the KCTK Radio app. You're listening and you're going, I don't need the app, but you do need the app. Here's why. It's free, okay? You already got Candy Crush, all kinds of jackleg apps on your phone.
It's free. It's free.
Yeah,
it's
just free. Get it for free. And then if you ever want to participate live sometime, you can put the notification on there. Also, you always can get the podcast on there as soon as they come out. So it's a fun thing to do. I'm asking you. I'm pleading with you. Please. You're going to have fun. I've noticed something about you. You need to relax a little bit. You know, you need to kind of chill out.
Get away from TikTok.
Yeah, get away from TikTok for a little bit and listen to the KCTK Radio app. It's free. It will get into your brain, and it will never leave you. So join us on the KCTK Radio app and have fun for once in your life. Do it. The KCTK podcast way.
I'm excited to tell you about Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing. Blue cheese dressing with a little kick. Bronco Blue is an artisan-made salad dressing dip created in small batches. It is like no other salad dressing you've ever had, and it's made right here in Kansas City. Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing is made by our favorite chef here in Kansas City, Stephanie Broncato. And Stephanie's been making this dressing since she was 10 years old. This is her secret recipe, and one of the only ones she won't share with you because it's that good. Bronco Blue is a small batch, artisan-made blue cheese dressing with only the finest ingredients, with no preservatives. It is like no other blue cheese dressing you've ever had. And you, folks, should try a jar today. You won't regret it. And you can get it by the pint or half pint, your choice. Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing, the official dressing of KCTK Radio. Now, I want you to go right now to www.broncobluecheesedressing.com. Again, it's www.broncobluecheesedressing.com to place your order today. Get Bronco blue cheese dressing with a little kick, and tell them that Bo, the official Bronco of Bronco Blue Cheese Dressing, sent you.
Usually use this time as a, you know, just highlight something that's going on, but this is my formal apology to everybody.
Oh.
Productivity in the last week has dropped dramatically from 12 to 2.
Huh?
That is when we started doing Forgotten Radio, a new program here at KCTK, and it's our friend who has a name. Jack is his name.
Oh,
he does Forgotten Radio, and puts themes together.
It's fun.
And you've listened to it, right?
Yeah.
And you're supposed to be working.
Yeah.
But you're not. You're listening to the Forgotten Radio.
I'm back in the olden days, man. I'm swimming in nostalgia, having fun. Yes.
And it goes kind of, it's radio stuff that you would hear in the past.
Mm-hmm.
But it, you recognize it. It's not so deep that you don't.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of fun. He puts a lot of work into it. It's on 12 to 2. Mm-hmm. You get a new episode on Tuesday. It repeats on 12 to 2 every day until next Tuesday.
Nice.
And I know what everyone's doing.
Having a long lunch break.
They're having a long lunch break and not getting things done. And I can apologize. Yeah. But if you want to not get things done too, get the KCTK radio app and at noon listen to Forgotten Radio.
Oh, okay.
It's fun.
Yeah, it is.
I mean, if you like fun.
It's okay.
And welcome back to Past Week, Next Week with Chris and Paul, starring Boogie, who's not here today.
I know.
And introducing the texter, who is here.
Yeah.
I don't know if we have any more updates.
I don't think we've gotten any more.
Have you replied back to him?
I just told him to keep everything coming that he could.
Okay. Good, good.
Yeah.
I want him to know that he is, we are listening to him and we appreciate that. We talked a lot of news and we're going to do the showbiz news. I just want to do a preference that, or a preference. I want to warn everyone, all these stories really deal with things that I really am into.
Oh, okay.
So well, just everyone be aware that I may have a few things to say about this.
Oh, I gotcha.
When it comes to showbiz news. Take it away, Chris.
Well, let's start with Hacks. Hacks pulls back the curtain on ruthlessness and Hollywood success. The third season of Hacks, the Emmy-nominated Max comedy series, has in one respect felt strangely dated, with veteran comic Deborah Vance pursuing a late-night TV show as a capper to her career at a time when those series have lost much luster from their heyday. Yet the show also contains what feels like a timeless lesson about Hollywood and doing anything to get ahead. The finale articulated that clearly after Deborah, Jean Smart, lied to her writer confidant Ava, Hannah Einbinder, telling her that the network had prevented her from installing Ava as the head writer on her show. As luck would have it, Ava had an encounter with a network boss, Helen Hunt, who made clear that choice belonged to Deborah, who later admitted as much.
Have you watched Hacks at all?
I am, well, it was a bit of a spoiler for me. I just finished episode 3 of season 3.
Okay. So kind of a spoiler that she does end up getting the show.
Yeah.
Kind of a spoiler on, but there's another spoiler.
Oh, really?
And it's awesome.
Okay, don't tell me.
It is so good. Hacks, I think it is hilarious.
Yes.
It deals a lot with generational.
Mm-hmm.
Issues,
mm-hmm.
Show business.
Yep.
And I really have this really, they have this really interesting dynamic where Hannah, played by, Ava is played by Hannah.
Yeah.
Did you know who Hannah's mom is?
Yeah. Lorraine Newman.
Yeah.
Yeah. Crazy.
And I love that actress. I think
she's great.
She's super cute and funny.
I think.
And a great, she gives off that. That is it Gen Z, whatever, just attitude. I just
I think she's a great actress.
You know, I hate it, but it's like, yeah, you're the right thing. And
yeah,
but these two people love each other,
mm-hmm.
And it's not sexual,
right?
It's not even like a mother daughter thing. They're skilled in their craft and they love working together.
Immense professional respect between the two of them.
Yes.
Immense.
But they truly do love each other and know that they're better for each other when they're together.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. And getting through the generational and the business and everything is with two people who want to make it and just are just fucked up people.
Well, I'm excited to finish it. So, I love the show. I think Jean Smart is such a great actress, too.
Yes, she's amazing.
Yeah.
She's amazing. So, check that at Hacks if you haven't seen it, okay?
Okay.
I can't wait to hear you hear what you have to say about the
Well, I'm excited to find out what it, yeah.
Okay, George Clooney and Brad Pitt reunite to action-packed Wolves trailer. Former co-star and real-life friends George Clooney and Brad Pitt become reluctant partners when they are both hired as fixers for the same job in the new trailer for the upcoming movie Wolves. The two are reuniting after working together in Joel and Ethan's Conan's Burning After Reading. I never saw that in 2008. They also starred together in Steven Soderbergh's Ocean's 11 franchise.
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen the preview? Have you seen the?
I've not seen the preview.
Dude,
for this.
It's awesome. It's but it's
are they werewolves?
It's Clooney and Pitt in their most Clooney and Pitt attitudes.
Okay. Okay. Yeah.
And do you remember the name of the fixer in Pulp Fiction?
The Wolf. Oh.
So that's, I think, where they're calling it, the
Wolf. That's all you had to say, Paul.
Yeah, thank you. They're both those guys.
Oh, wow.
And that
okay.
whole attitude and chemistry between those two are, it looks so awesome. And I don't remember being this excited about a movie coming out.
Well, gosh, I hope it's good, man.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, that's cool. Oh, wait.
Oh, back to you, Chris.
Oh, thanks, Paul. Sorry. The Beach Boys catches the boomer wave of golden oldie music documentaries. Pardon me. Streaming has yielded bounties in numerous areas, but nowhere more than in the field of music rockumentaries catering to baby boomers. Those projects have also been enriched not just by nostalgia for great acts, but by weaving their soundtracks into the evolution of the culture through tumultuous times in the 1960s and 70s. Add two more projects to that tally this week. The Beach Boys, an ode to the band that gave the world the surf sound and whose members, among other things, crossed paths with the Manson family. And Stax Soulville USA, HBO's multi-part look at the Memphis music label that champions such artists as Otis Redding and Isaac Hayes.
I'm loving Stax Soulville USA.
Oh, is it good? Yes. I was considering whether I wanted to watch that or not.
Yes, and so many good musicians, and they kind of fell upon it and talks about the struggles and how involved they were with the civil rights movement. In fact, they all were together when Martin Luther King got shot because they were all hanging out at the same hotel.
Uh-huh.
And it's really very interesting. And I'll watch the Beach Boys one as well.
Mm-hmm.
I love music documentaries.
They're fun.
For a guy who's not a musician.
Yeah.
I just love, and I think it's just learning how the creativity of working together and trying to come up with something creative when you're in a group. I watched Let It Be, which was different from Get Back. They took different footage and the Let It Be movie was the old movie, but they re-digitalized it.
Okay.
It's all fascinating to me. And you would think, oh, he must be a musician of some sort. No.
Yeah.
Not at all. I respect him from afar and not enough to pick up a guitar and try to learn how to play.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a lot of good music, Doc. The Eagles one I loved.
Oh, that was awesome.
And just hearing the stories of how those, like, they cross paths with other famous musicians, but, like, before they were all famous. And,
yes.
Yeah, cool stories. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, Paul.
And finally, Hollywood stares into another cruel summer, it's probably too soon to panic. The Fall Guy landed below expectations. If didn't have enough friends to buy tickets, imaginary otherwise. Oh. A Mad Max saga, a Garfield movie won't make anyone forget Barbenheimer. As a summer movie going season lurks beyond Memorial Day, Hollywood dreams of continuing to recover from box office losses associated with COVID and the advent of streaming hasn't materialized, with results lagging far behind May 2023. When Guardians of the Galaxies patrolled theaters. While the industry needs to be seriously adjust expectations and perhaps begin to accept what was once considered box office mediocrity as the new norm, it's probably too soon to panic yet. Now, you go to movies.
Not as much as I used to, but I do love the theater experience.
Okay. We were talking about this before. Things change, folks. I don't know if we're ever getting it back.
I don't know. Yeah.
And for a while, it was, we'll just do a superhero movie.
Yeah.
That doesn't work anymore, does it?
Mm-mm.
Thanks, Flash.
Well, don't forget Aquaman.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Or you want to forget Aquaman.
I want to forget it. It's terrible.
Yeah.
But this Clooney and Pitt's movie, it is on Apple.
Yep.
I think it's going to go to theaters, but I don't know if I'll watch it at theaters.
I know. It's hard, man. Yeah. And like I said, I just don't go to the theater much anymore. And when I do, there's five or six of us in the theater watching. Yeah. Oh, man, there's a great movie on Apple, if you haven't seen it. The Beanie Bubble.
The Beanie Bubble.
It's about the Beanie Baby craze.
Oh, wow.
And Zach Galifianakis plays the weird guy that owns the Beanie Baby company. It's so good.
Now, last time I talked about the Unfrosted.
Yeah. Yes.
And you finally saw it, right?
I did.
You liked it too, didn't you?
I did, yeah. I had a great time. It was silly. It was ridiculous. It was fun. But boy, critics sure didn't care for it, but I thought it was a great time at the movies.
I actually heard one critic say, well, that's not actually factual what happened. It's like, no shit.
Yes, right. Right.
It is like what a little kid would think would have happened.
Yes, yeah.
Which is kind of the thing. Jerry Seinfeld is talking to a little kid about it.
Yes. That's how the whole show starts out.
Right? Yep. And then there was a criticism. Well, that's not like Seinfeld. That's not like the TV show. Here's why it is like it. Why was the TV show Seinfeld so good? Because it had good writing and great actors.
Yes.
Was Jerry you're going to do good if you call him the fourth funniest person on the show.
Absolutely.
Okay. That's exactly what he did in this movie.
Mm-hmm.
He's not the funniest guy in the show near it, but he's the
anchor, the glue. Yeah.
And so many funny things happening around him.
Yeah. And all the cameos, just that alone is so fun.
What'd you think of Chef Boyardee?
Oh, dude, every time he was on the screen, I was giggling. He was great.
That's not how he really was.
What? That's not. I love Jack LaLanne, too. I mean, my gosh, it was great. It was great.
Hey, we have a kind of a special feature, and I know you guys are excited about it. It is called Going Through Some Videos that Paul saw.
Oh, okay.
Usually I talk about this on What Happened.
Yeah.
This is the Augie Doggy song.
What? Augie Doggy?
Yeah. One of the...
And Doggy Daddy?
Augie Doggy and Doggy Daddy.
Yeah.
There is a one of the colleges that Joseph is looking at. It's called the Augies.
Yeah. Augustana. Yep.
Yeah. So here, that's kind of a tip of the hat.
Nice.
Okay. Let's take a look at... this is just a typical... I didn't even know where to start, so if I'm not in very good order here, it's okay.
I mean, so far it's going swimmingly.
Do you remember Augie Doggy?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
And Doggy Daddy.
It wasn't the greatest, but it was fun, and you watched it.
Yeah, if it was on, I watched it.
Yeah.
Television was my friend.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's start with this one, then. Okay, here's a video, and I didn't really label these very well, so we're just going to react to them.
Okay.
Once they play.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Actually, you can react now if you want, but...
I don't know what I'm reacting to. It's the hard thing.
Well, that's the thing. You're reacting to nothing.
Yeah.
But a lot of times... I'll get these ready to go here.
All righty.
Oh, okay. Yeah. There.
So... It's old cartoon videos that you're going to be showing here?
No, just stuff from the news.
Oh, okay. Okay, see.
Okay, so for those of you that are having a tissy fit over Donald Trump being convicted on 34 felony counts and about to be convicted on several others, that's cool. Here's what I want you to remember. I want you to remember the fact that you are worshiping this politician because he is a racist and a misogynist, and mainly because you really, really, really didn't like it that a black person was a president in the Oval Office. Same thing happened for Reconstruction after the slaves were free. Same thing happened with Jim Crow era. It's always when anybody who is black takes one step forward, you make sure that they're put in their place and take two steps back. You were so upset bets that it was a black person in the Oval Office. You went, I want the most racist, idiotic person. I don't care what they say. I'm going to trust them no matter what. Even now, when you tell us that there's no way he's going to be found guilty, and now he is, you're still going to vote for him even when he's in jail because of your absolute hatred toward progress in this country. Do not claim that you're a patriot. Do not claim that you're the party of law and order, because we now all know that that is a big fucking lie. Okay, good talk, bye.
There's no way he just said that. I'm not racist. He's racist. And I'm going to show him with my comments.
Stop. Stop. Go cry somewhere else. Bye.
Okay. That we should play every episode to everyone. Just drop the mic. He just, in a short video, in 1 minute, just said what's going really on.
I think with a lot of people, that is absolutely true. I do think there are others.
So the other news that I heard is that 49% of the people in a poll said that the stock market is at an all-time low.
Are you serious?
So.
Oh my God.
If you believe that this verdict was rigged, mm-hmm. if you believe that it's the economy is in shambles, then that's the problem,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're only listening to what you want to listen to.
Yes. Echo chamber, baby.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the problem is the echo chamber. And then I also saw a poll this morning that said 57% of the country poll of the polling said that this was a proper conviction.
Oh.
Okay.
57, okay.
Oh, that's nice. 43% said no.
Yeah. Yep.
Isn't that just mind-boggling?
I don't understand it. I don't understand it.
Well, here's the other thing they keep talking about, too. That the mainstream media, and they stink, by the way.
Oh,
they
yeah.
are not serving us whatsoever.
No.
They said, well, it's not really going to matter because only about 2% of the people will even change their vote.
Wow.
Okay. Guess what? That means Joe Biden wins.
I know. It does.
So keep saying that. Oh, it doesn't matter. It's only 2%.
Mm-hmm.
You idiots.
Hey, take it.
But we're just down this. This guy said what the problem is. You know, you have the same Fox quote news, unquote news says, oh my gosh, look how terrible Black Lives Matter protests were and mm-hmm. crime is bad. But then they have no respect for the judicial system whatsoever.
Mm-hmm.
It's because of this race thing, man.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is. I'm sorry to say.
I do think there are other people that are going to support Trump no matter what because he says he's pro-life, and that is the only thing that they vote on.
You think so?
I do. Yeah. I do. A smaller group, but I do that. As long as you virtue signal, you're going to get the vote.
So we already did the biggest character, but I want to show you this real quick.
Oh, okay.
I know this is an audio thing, but folks.
He's funny, you know, and it's kind of a natural thing for him. And so he's just really easy.
Oh, your face. Oh, that's awesome.
Okay, that was one thing to look at. Here's a typical MAGA supporter.
You know, I wish all
mad.
These athletes would shut up about politics and just play sports.
Wait. This is we go back to Harrison Buckner, and this is some of his supporters.
Oh, okay.
Okay. And I'm glad the texter brought it up.
You know, I wish all these athletes would shut up about politics and just play sports.
Mm-hmm.
And that, unless they believe exactly what I believe, and then in that case, you people, and I do mean you people, need to stop trying to censor their freedom of speech. You know, Harrison butt kicker, he's just telling it like it is. And if you can't handle it, then that's too damn bad. Because he laid into Joe Brandon. I agree with Harrison. He said, Joe, you can't be Catholic and pro-choice. That's an oxymoron, which is not to be confused with a moron on oxy, which is what your son is, Joe.
Oh, snap. Talk.
You're Catholic, Joe. You need to get your hypocrisy straight. I'm so pissed off at Joe Brandon for being pro-choice and not like the move him to a different parish pissed off. I'm talking like the real kind of pissed off. For real. And butt kicker, he's smart. He's got an engineering degree.
Butt kicker.
I call it ED for short, but he's got ED, and he graduated. MAGA yelled loudly, and he stood up there at MAGA the graduation. Yelled loudly. And he looked at all them women that they just got their BAs and their MDs and their PhDs, and he said, you know, that's all fine and good, ladies, but you need to get a real degree. Get you an MRS degree and find you a husband and find your vocation. And let me mansplain something to you women. If you don't know how to find your vocation, it's easy. All you got to do is find a man, marry him, and then he will tell you your vocation. And Catholic survey says, ding, 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 homemaker. That's your vocation. And that's a cushy job. It's easy. All you got to do is find a man that makes $3 million a year, and then you can spend the rest of your life making babies. Because as us Catholics say, fill the collection plate, not the condom. Ladies, if you don't want to be a homemaker, that's fine. You're free to be whatever you want, as long as it's a stewardess, a waitress, a maid, or a nun. Because God forbid somebody like Harrison Buttkicker has a heart attack, and he's laying there clutching his chest, and he says, help, I'm having a heart attack. Is there a doctor in the house? And the lady runs up, and she says, I'm a doctor. I can help. And he's like, no, you should be at home cooking and cleaning and pushing out babies. Is there a male doctor in the house? And a man runs up, and he says, I can help. But the guy's he's got a rainbow shirt on. And he's like, no, I see where this is going. Is there a straight, white, male doctor who believes exactly what I believe in the house? And it turns out there's not. And God forbid Harrison dies. And then his death is on your hands, ladies.
That's the great Brett Therhune.
He's good.
Who does these videos and he's parodying. It's like a parody of MAGA people.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I don't know how you parody. I mean, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. I bet there's some people out there who'd watch it. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I know when he first started, that happened all the time. Yeah. He's good.
He's real good. So
great stand-up. Seriously. See him if he's in your town.
Thanks, Chris.
Sure.
And so this is a video. It's a little longer. Just smart enough. Oh, man. We're not going to watch the whole thing, but we want our democracy back.
Sure.
We're frustrated with the MAGA people. We aren't super jumping up and down about our presidential candidate.
I know.
But there's only this video shows the only way to get out of it.
Oh, okay.
Okay, here we go.
To realize that there is an unresponsive duopoly in our government that has experienced complete regulatory capture from corporations, so they can't respond to anything. But I'm too dumb to do anything about it. All I'm like is like, I guess vote? But that clearly doesn't work.
Here's three steps to fix all of the problems that you said in that video. You don't have to be an expert in history or how the government works to do them. This video only comes in three steps. So if you don't feel like paying attention to all three steps, I guess you just don't care enough about changing it. Here's the first part out of all three, which is the claim that voting doesn't work. We live in the United States of America, which has one of the lowest voter turnout rates of any of our peer countries. We don't know that voting doesn't work. We've never tried it. This is especially true for young voters.
How about
we don't vote especially...
How about that?
Wow. Yeah.
So when a young person says, oh, voting doesn't work, the answer is you've never done it. We've never done it before.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems to work for older people.
It does work for older people. And I don't know why the U.S. This is not a new thing. The U.S. has been very low in voter turnout for years and years. I don't know why we don't do it.
I think it's a combination of making it difficult. It's
Yeah.
There's so many elections that we have. The election cycle is long. It's hard to get there on that day. All this stuff. But also people are so goddamn lazy and entitled that they want. I mean, I order stuff on Amazon. Where is it? It comes in 2 days? It's a 1 day. What?
Yeah.
It just. It's a little bit of effort that you don't want to do. And I get it. I would say don't do it. Just do it every 2 years. If that makes it easier for you, just show up on those times.
Yeah. We are barreling toward WALL-E, the Pixar movie. We just don't do anything.
Yeah.
Our shit gets delivered to our front door. Our food gets delivered to our front door. We sit around like, man.
But I just don't understand. It's like, okay, we see what's happening. There's only one way to move ahead. I used to do a thing. I'd go around and I'd talk about getting involved politically.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a forced choice. You got to vote for the person that best is your philosophy. You got to look through those things.
Yeah.
Okay. Because, and this is the other people don't talk about, politicians will move to get their votes. You're their only employee evaluation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Right.
If you hate red ties,
mm-hmm.
and your decision is you're not voting for anyone that wears a red tie.
Okay.
And you get enough people to make that their thing. Politicians will stop wearing red ties.
You're right.
But if you sit there and say, well, both are wearing red ties, I'm not going to vote.
Yeah.
You got to look and see, well, 10 times out of, or 5 times out of 10, he wears a red tie, but 5 times he does it. This guy wears it 8 times out of a red tie. You know what I mean?
Yes. Yeah. Silly example, but you're spot on. Yes.
It's going to happen that way.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Especially in congressional elections, and we need to. And it's not just congressional elections, it's primaries too. We're super mad at Biden, but you know what? Only 25.9% of us voted in the primaries.
But the DNC in 2016 with Bernie Sanders.
Yes, the DNC shat in all of our cereal in 2016, but we were the ones who decided just to give up and not go and vote. Uh-huh. So first off, let's say you're just talking about the delegates. We never got to that point because Bernie Sanders didn't win the vote. If he would have won the vote and he still didn't get all of his delegates, then that would have been a different discussion. But we never made it to that point. We never got to the point where we would find out.
But the DNC suppressed him. We didn't know that we needed to vote for Bernie because they suppressed all the news articles about him. And they suppressed him at debates. We didn't know to vote for Bernie.
Yes, we did. If we look this up, we can tell very plainly that on the internet, people were talking about Bernie Sanders during the primary season more than they were talking about Hillary Clinton. And that was nationwide. We supported Bernie Sanders. We liked Bernie Sanders. We wanted to help Bernie Sanders. We never showed up to vote for him. In the Democratic primaries of 2016, only about 30...
I would say that people who did support him did show up and vote for him.
Yeah, there were people that did.
What the Democratic Party doesn't understand, and I think the president plays too much into radical left.
Mm-hmm.
I think he does that too much.
Yeah.
They don't have the votes.
No. No, they don't.
They just don't.
Yeah, you're right about that. And and I do wish Joe Brandon would not play into that as much.
Okay. Where's number two this guy has?
Yeah, let's see his number two. He goes on for a while about the voting.
He sure does. I don't know.
Okay. Well,
we get the point. I don't know what things were. Things were, you got to vote.
You got to vote. Yeah.
So for the until November, okay, I'm not really excited about Joe Biden. I'm upset with the way Israel's doing the war.
Mm-hmm.
I think inflation is too high, which it isn't, but it's still a lot higher than it was, and things cost more.
Yeah.
I want the president to talk more about that. Here's how great we've done since COVID, but we also need to do this.
Yeah.
Like a minimum wage increase, stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I can't get this whole guy to do it. But no. I guarantee you he's going to do better than the guy running against him.
Absolutely.
So, yes, criticize and then say, yeah, I'm going to go vote
mm-hmm.
for him because that's better.
It makes sense.
My fear is that as we become this entitled group, that the generation that needs to vote hasn't seen it work ever in the history of their time. Not that I have either, really.
But you're afraid they'll get completely disillusioned and then it just won't happen?
Yeah, and it's just too far gone. So Trump says to oil contributors, if you give me $1 billion, I'll get reverse all the environmental constraints. Where did you see that in the news? Why isn't that every fucking minute that happens?
I have no idea.
It's just downplay. Oh, that's just what Trump does.
Yeah. But he just talks. He just talks.
But supposedly, the younger generation that doesn't vote, not that we did when we were younger, okay, they care about the environment. There it is right there, folks. Mm-hmm. Is someone going to get rid of all constraints against climate change legislation, or is someone going to try to have some? Mm-hmm. Pick one.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he's not doing enough for it. Okay.
Well, he's doing something.
Yes.
Yeah. He's not reversing everything.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it ain't going to work, is it?
No. Well, I'm still convinced Joe Biden's going to win in November. I'm convinced he will.
Mm-hmm.
But.
Well, and here's another thing I hear. Well, I don't know about Joe Biden because I don't like Kamala Harris. I would take Kamala Harris before Trump any day of the week.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
And I think, I really believe that is, underlying sexism that people had towards Hillary Clinton.
Mm-hmm.
I wish Hillary Clinton would have never ran. I think people were like, Clinton, come on.
Yeah. Yeah.
But she's smart. She is. I would like to see President Biden in a second term put Hillary Clinton on the Supreme Court. That would be awesome. Fucking awesome.
Yes.
And then Claire McCaskill as Attorney General. Okay.
Yeah.
Because we finally have people with, pardon my language, with balls doing something.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
But I think this negativism towards Harris is more sexist than even racist.
Wow. I'm sure it's both, though.
I think it is both.
Yeah.
Because what has she done? Nothing.
Nothing.
Okay.
Yeah. Right.
So,
yeah.
You hate her because she's done nothing?
I just don't like her.
That's what every freaking vice president has done in the history of time.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Oh.
That's our special feature. Do you think going to Europe, you won't come back?
I think I'll come back, but I would say I doubt it will happen, but I am at least open to retiring someplace else, and at least for a while. So
yeah. Isn't that sad?
Yeah, it is sad. It really is, but yeah. You know, if I had the money, maybe I would retire for a few years in Portugal or somewhere. Yeah. And yeah, just get away for a while.
Speaking of get away, let's do headlines and predictions.
Oh, yeah.
Do we have any texts that we need to...
No more texts have come through, so I can only assume that his plane went down. Okay, and folks, again, this is where we take actual news stories ripped from the headlines and we write our own punchlines to them.
There's no other thing that could have happened.
Except his plane went down. Do you know how bad I'm going to feel if that actually happened?
Terrible.
Okay, here we go. A New York jury found Donald Trump guilty of all 34 counts of falsifying business records in his hush money criminal trial, a historic verdict that makes him the first former president in U.S. history to be convicted of a felony. Trump faces a possibility of a prison sentence or probation for his crimes stemming from a hush money payment scheme. A felony conviction of a former president or party frontrunner is unprecedented, but Trump, who is the presumptive 2024 Republican nominee, can still run for office. He just can't vote for himself, visit many of our closest allies, or buy a Derringer for his tiny hands. Paul?
Thanks, Chris.
Sure.
President Joe Biden has given permission to Ukraine to carry out limited strikes inside Russia territory with American munitions. The loosening of the restrictions marked the break from longstanding policy and comes amid growing international pressure from close U.S. allies. The potential strikes will be limited to the area around Kiev, U.S. officials say, after Russia made significant advances around the city. In response, full-time excrementer and Putin fallaciist Tucker Carlson complained that this violates the Russia should be able to do whatever they want doctrine of the GOP. Chris?
It's true. It's just true. The statistics of more than 2,300 Negro League baseball players shut out of Major League Baseball are now reflected in official record books. Kansas City Negro League's Baseball Museum president Bob Kendrick said the newly integrated books can be a gateway to understanding an era not only of segregation, but also of perseverance. The statistical changes come after 4 years of research, spurred by a 2020 MLB decision to officially recognize Negro League players as Major League caliber. Wow, what's next? Are they going to try and make us believe that Dominicans and Puerto Ricans are also Major League caliber? Paul.
Thanks, Chris. Sure. And what a great take on that.
Thank you. I worked on that one for a
minute.
That's
really awesome. The main power utility of Hawaii was cut off electricity to some areas in future extreme weather conditions to avoid another wildfire disaster. The planned shutoff are in response to last year's fire that killed more than 100 people in the island of Maui and caused $6 billion in damages. High winds and red flag warnings were issued on the day of the devastating fires, but the community siren warning system did not sound, which is similar to corporate media's full report on Trump's demand for $1 billion in donations to stop climate change initiatives. It did not sound.
Oh, dude, you did a hook back. That was great.
And I wanted, because the fire happened because of climate change. Back to you, Chris.
Oh, that was good, man. Thanks, Paul. The Japanese eating legend who won 6 consecutive Nathan's hot dog eating contests is retiring because he literally no longer has the hunger to compete. 46-year-old Takura Kobayashi made the announcement after doctors discovered his brain had become repelled by highly processed foods. If only that could happen for the biggest character in the entire lead program at the Independence Chamber of Commerce. Paul.
Fuck you, Chris. I mean, thank you, Chris. And finally, by the way, folks, I do try to have funny jokes for everyone, but this is for my friend Chris.
Oh, okay.
Melissa's Produce, a California-based seller of specialty fruit and vegetables, is selling the Ruby Glow pineapple, which is bred for its distinctive red exterior and its sweetness, for $395.99. Word is it took Del Monte a decade and a half to develop the red-hued fruit, which is grown in Costa Rica. It is part of a recent renewed interest in premium fruit. Melissa's Produce, which sells everything from truffles to mangosteens to kumquats, described Ruby Reds as the pinnacle of luxury fruit, which, of course, was Paul Lynn's nickname in the 1970s.
Oh, yes! That was awesome!
Yay!
I even mentioned Paul Lynn earlier in the program, too.
Yes.
Oh, that's amazing. That's amazing, dude. Good.
The pinnacle of luxury fruit.
Thank you. Thank you.
That's what he was. He was the pinnacle of luxury fruit. Paul Lynn.
Oh, Paul Lynn. I loved Hollywood Squares.
Ah. One thing that we wanted to talk about, which it's going to be way too in the past, but we did this. They did the show, John Mulaney Show. Did you watch it?
I watched part of the first episode, and then I just kind of forgot about it.
And Boogie claims it was a lot like past week.
Right, right.
Which made me
is another show I've never listened to. So, yeah.
Some people are saying, oh, it's so messy, and John loves it. He's leaning into the chaos. Just to be clear, I'm trying to do a good job. This is me organized.
So, I thought that would be important.
Oh, that's awesome. That is awesome. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, Chris, what do you got going on the next time? Next week,
dude, I'm gonna be leaving on a jet plane, and I actually do know when I'll be back again, but heading to Europe with some dear friends. This is gonna be awesome.
And you're leaving Friday morning?
We're leaving Friday morning.
What time you leave?
We 8 a.m from Kansas City.
Oh, okay.
Fly to Chicago, and we changed it. I just, after being delayed 12 hours going to San Diego, I'm like, I don't want to miss this. So, and I've not had good luck with planes taking off on time for me. So we'll be there a day before you.
And then Sunday, at about 8 a.m.
Yeah.
In Rome, Rome time.
Yeah.
You'll be meeting me in the Rome airport.
Correct.
Roma. Yeah. I don't understand, Chris, language. You have a master's in English.
English,
which
yeah.
which is a language.
It is, yeah.
So why do we call it Rome? They call it Roma.
I don't know.
You know what I'm saying? It doesn't make sense. When you go over there, you're not Whitetino, you're Whiting. You're still your same name.
Right.
The city has the same name. It's called Roma.
Right.
Why don't we call it Roma?
I don't know.
It's a proper noun.
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay.
Dude, I have no idea.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I guess we'll...
Maybe we can ask them.
So I'm going to Roma.
I don't know. You'll ask them.
And we'll meet you there in Roma, which is exciting.
I am so excited.
And you'll find us at the, I guess, Delta...
We'll probably just be where you come out of the, you know, after you go through customs. We will have done it like a day before. So
we're
going to
go get
our
bags.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You got to get your bags.
Yeah, we got to get our.
Yeah. Yeah. OK.
So we'll meet you there.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah,
I guess.
It's going to be awesome.
So that's great. Do you have like a bunch of work this week you got to get done? And
I mean, yeah, it's the work is crazy. There probably couldn't be a worse time for me to be going. We're launching two of my major initiatives while I'm gone.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, what are you going to do, baby?
Yeah. I mean,
I'm going to love it. I'm going to enjoy it.
It's just the way it is, right?
Yeah.
I'll be joining you there. And, so Sicily should be, I can't wait to show you Sicily too. We're going to go. If we have time, I don't know if we'll have time. I think we will. Would you want to go see Sambuca? I would. You'll love it.
Okay. Sure.
It's where my great, great grandfather and grandmother are from.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Yeah. And I've told you this embarrassing story about going there the first time, right? I grew up in a society, misogynist society, folks.
Uh-huh.
Okay. I'm not proud of it. So we went there with Nancy's cousin.
Yeah.
And we went to the city hall to try to find records of where my great-grandfather was born in that city.
Right.
He was born in 1871.
Wow.
We looked for the name Lavota. No, there's no such name. That wasn't his name when he was born. We looked for Sparacinco, which was his father's name.
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't find anything.
Oh, wow.
He was... illegitimate child.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
So there's no record of him. Darn, we can't find any record. I didn't look for Lucia Maggio, who's my great-great-grandmother.
Oh. Wow.
I only looked for my great-great-grandfather.
Interesting.
Isn't that disgusting?
Yeah. Yeah. I get it.
And then later I thought, she was born there. She was a legitimate... child.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's records, she's probably there.
Yeah.
So I don't know if we'll waste time to go in there and do that again, because it really doesn't make a difference. You know,
it doesn't, but it's cool.
Yeah.
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 Hey, but good for you. Molly would say, you know, you recognizing that and then talking about it is a compassionate correction on your part.
Thank you,
so,
Molly.
Good job.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So there you go. I don't know what else to say, folks. We're going to have our pop-up shows, and then we'll give you an update there. Oh, looks like we already got that from Boogie.
Okay.
Hopefully we'll hear from him and kind of go from there. So let's just stop the show already, right?
Yeah, okay, let's do it. Oh, hey, everyone. Thanks for listening to Past Week Next Week with Chris and Paul, starring Boogie and introducing the Texter. Since you love the program, please rate and review the podcast on your favorite podcast distributor. We'd love to hear from you, and you can contact us at 913-735-0060. Also, join the Past Week Next Week Facebook page. On behalf of Paul, I'm Chris saying goodbye.
And on behalf of Chris, I want to play a song called... and Boogie and Texter, even though they're called Hold On, I'm Coming. This is for the whole continent.
Oh, okay.
It's from Chris and Paul to the continent of Europe.
And
it is Sam and Dave.
Oh, yeah.
Sam and Dave are highly featured in the Stax.
Oh, okay. And well, I'm going to have to watch it.
They were like the first stars from them.
I'm digging the dance.
You might see me doing that at the discotheque.
And the thing about Sam and Dave, too, is amazing how great their songs are. But a lot of their songs, you're like, oh, okay. They did them, and then someone else did them later.
Yeah.
Like this one. I'm trying to think of who.
Yeah, I wonder.
Was it?
I don't know
Steve
if that's
Steve Winwood or somebody. But look how cool they danced, too.
Yeah, man. I am really digging that.
I think Steve Winwood did Hold On, I'm Coming.
Okay, that might be worth a Google. Let's see here. You know, if I could type.
One thing that's really interesting about is that they had trouble getting into regular radio until they did a trip to England.
Yeah. Right?
They loved him over there.
Oh, wow.
And the guy who was running the promotion said, I've been so reluctant. He said he was so reluctant getting into white radio.
Uh-huh.
He saw all those white faces and white kids love their music in Britain. He's like, well, I'm not doing that anymore. I'm going after white people who like this music.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Michael Bolton did it in 1992.
He sure did.
Yeah. And he hasn't done it since. Aretha Franklin, too, 1981. So how about them apples? That was a weird shot.
Yeah. A lot of the music from the documentary, I'm like, I know that song.
Yeah.
Because the Blues Brothers did it.
One
of the main guys who in the band, who's the guitar player, that may even be him right back there. He was in the Blues Brothers band.
Was he the Matt Guitar Murphy guy?
No, another guy.
Okay.
Cooper, I think is his name.
Okay. These fellas can really belt it out there, man. Mm-hmm. Don't you wish you could sing, like, really good?
Yes, it'd be so awesome.
Yeah. I wish I could sing good, or I was at least really, really good looking.
Yes. Which one would you pick?
Singing.
I would, too.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think I'm not a handsome person, but I'm good enough figure I could pull it off if I sang good.
Yeah.
You know?
Hey, Susan Boyle did it.
Yeah.
For crying out loud. You're at least as attractive as her.
That's the nicest thing anyone's ever said to me.
Holy cow, this is a long rendition.
This has been a KCTK production, produced by Paul Lavona. If you want more information about this content, then you have some real weirdness going on. You can always check out KCTK Radio on Facebook. Listen to live programs at kctkradio.com. Yes, and that is on the World Wide Web. Thank you.